Hi everyone, welcome back to the Toronto Zoo for another Facebook Live. My name's Ryan. I'm a keeper here in the Tundra Trek section of the zoo. Our mission at the Toronto Zoo is to connect people, animals, and conservation science to fight extinction. And one of the ways we're still able to do that while we're closed is to connect with you and teach you about our amazing animals we have here at the zoo. So you've already been to the Tundra Trek twice now. You've met our polar bears and you've met our Arctic fox. But today we're actually going to introduce you to two more residents of the Tundra Trek. And this first one, I consider a bit of a hidden gem at the zoo, or at the Tundra Trek of the zoo. So we're going to go get him right now, and I'm going to escort him to his exhibit. So follow me. So this is the house that they sleep in at night, and we walk them to their exhibit every day. So let's see if he's going to come out and join me. See if I can hold this door open. You might need to stand back just a little. You might be a little nervous that there's extra people here today. So I don't know if you got a glimpse of him, but we're gonna introduce you to our snow geese. Now we have three snow geese here at the zoo. It doesn't look like he wants to come out, but you know, that's a part of working with animals. They don't always do what you want them to do, and you kind of just have to go with the flow. Maybe we'll stand back right here. And if you just wait one moment, I'm going to go get the snow goose. This is my buddy Han. So we actually walk them to their exhibit every day. So follow me, I'm gonna walk him to his exhibit because the house that they sleep in is actually not connected to their exhibit. So we have to escort them to their exhibit every day. So we have our nice relaxing walk with our snow goose. Like I was saying, we have three snow geese here at the zoo. We have a pair that live together. And then this guy here, his name's Han. So his name's actually given to him because it's Han Solo. So he actually likes his alone time. He's not a fan of our other two snow geese. So he lives on his own. And we walk him out to our exhibit just like this every day. They know exactly where they need to go. And I've already got his food and water set up. And he's got this nice big exhibit to hang out here. And snow geese, some of their favorite food are greens. So we actually give them quite a few different types of greens. He's gonna come and say hi to me or yell at me, one or the other. But we give them lettuce, dandelion greens, and spinach. And you see, he's very talkative. He likes to chat to us every day, scold us if we've been bad. Right, hon? All right. So that's Han, our snow goose. Now I'm going to throw it over to Erica, who's going to teach you a little bit about our caribou.
Hi guys, so my name is Erica. I'm also one of the keepers here in the Tundra Trek area. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about our caribou. First, let's just kind of meet them up close. Maybe we'll take you in and show you what they're doing right now. So this is their exhibit. It's quite a big exhibit, lots of space. We've given them a little bit of their hay right now. These guys also get some herbivore pellets, which we've gotten some enrichment devices we're gonna put out in a second. We do have a good sized group in here. Further back, you can see kind of their exhibit goes back. We're hoping to go back there after. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about our caribou. These guys are actually called porcupine caribou, and so they actually get their name from where they calve during their calving season. And so that's in the Porcupine, near the Porcupine River. These guys are have a large migratory distance. They'll actually travel all the way up towards Yukon and Alaska. These guys are the only deer species where both males and females have antlers. Now the males do have larger antlers than the females. And they do actually drop their antlers at different times of year. So the males will drop their antlers in the fall. And as you can see right now, some of our caribou do have antlers right now. So these guys are all females. And that's because they'll drop their antlers. They're in the process of dropping their antlers now. And they keep their antlers in order to protect their kids when they're born, which is usually around June. So I'm going to pass off to Ryan, who's going to kind of introduce you to our caribou.
All right. Hi, guys. Me again. So I'm going to show you all of our caribou. I'm going to introduce you to them by name. So we have 9 caribou here and 1 reindeer. And when we get to our reindeer, I'll show you the differences of them. So right here, so I know them by their ear tags. So I do have to see their ear tag. This is Daphne. She's one of our older caribou. She is 11 years old. And then we have Muriel here. That's another one of our older caribou. This one here, let me see, who do I have here? This is M6, this is Matilla. Again, another one of our older ones. So we have a couple that are, were born in 2009. And then we have a couple in this herd that are only 2 years old. This one here, this is Hyacinth. She's one of our younger ones. She is 4 years old. So follow me. I'm going to introduce you to the rest of them. This one here, this is Raven. Right here is Snowy. Now, Snowy is our reindeer. So all the rest that I've been introducing you to are caribou. And Snowy is our one reindeer. And you might be wondering, why do we have one reindeer in the herd? Now, back a couple years ago in our Eurasia Wild section, we actually used to have an exhibit for European reindeer. And that was an exhibit that Snowy used to live in. And then when we built our Tundra Trek area, we were switching over to caribou and we still had reindeer. So they moved over here and Snowy is our remaining European reindeer. Now they're basically the same type of animal, but you can see some slight differences. Reindeer are slightly a little bit more stocky, a little bit shorter, and you can see they have a darker coloration of their fur in their face. Now, I'm missing a couple caribou. Follow me. Now, we're not supposed to have favorites, but this one has a special place in my heart. This one here is Meadow. And Meadow is one of our younger ones. She is 2 years old. And the easiest way to tell Meadow from the others is she has really light markings above her eye. Now, Meadow actually just lost one of her antlers right before we started this Facebook Live. So she had 2 cute little antlers right before this, and one just fell off. And here it is, Erica's got it. So that's what their antlers look like. And like Erica was saying, they drop off every spring, and the females keep them longer because they are used to help protect their calves. Whereas the males, they drop them off in the fall after rut because they finished fighting with other males and they don't have any purpose for them anymore. One really unique thing about caribou and reindeer is females they're the only animal where females grow antlers, whereas all the other deer species, only the males get antlers. So that's pretty a unique thing about caribou. Now, I'm missing a couple. Oh, here we go. This is Delilah and Rosa. And I think I got everyone. I apologize if I missed anyone. Now, part of our care that we provide for our caribou is we train them every morning. So they actually voluntarily participate in their own active health care. So we're gonna see if one of them will follow us. We'll try and, I'm not sure where Raven is. There she is. So we'll try and get Raven to follow us. And one of Raven's favorite treats is bananas. Raven goes bananas for bananas. So we're gonna see if she'll follow us and do a little training session with us. So follow us. She might not join us, but we're gonna see if she will. Here she comes. Now, if you have any questions, feel free to send them in. Now, you might be wondering why their fur looks a little kind of like a kid took a hair clipper to them. They kind of look a little disheveled. This is the time of year where their hair falls off. So they have a really thick, dense layer of fur. They actually have two layers. There's a thick undercoat, which keeps them nice and warm in those cold tundra climates. And then they have a longer coarse hair that is actually hollow, and it helps pull air down into their skin and helps trap it to keep it warm. Now, caribou, they have some other really amazing adaptations to help them stay warm in those cold, frigid temperatures. One of those adaptations is their nose. So they actually have fur all over their nose, unlike a lot of other deer, where their nose is wet and hairless. So that's just another way they can keep their nose nice and warm. And another thing about their nose is that it actually has a really large surface area inside. And the purpose of that is when they take in a breath of air, there's a lot of surface area for that cold air to warm up before it reaches their lungs. So it's another way that they have adapted to stay warm in those cold temperatures. Now, if you were able to see some of their feet when we were introducing you to them all, you can see that they have actually really wide, flat hooves. And the purpose of those wide, flat hooves are to act like snowshoes. So they can travel through the snow really easily. So now we're at the caribou house. So this is where caribou come every morning to get their breakfast. And we get them to voluntarily participate in this training every morning. So Raven's gonna follow Erica, and she is going to come into our little chute system we have here. So we're just gonna try and get Raven to come over. Here she comes, star pupil. So this is our little chute system, and we give them a breakfast and snack in this little chute system every morning. And this is an excellent way for us to, one, form a bond with these animals, get to know them, but also to get a really close look at them. So we're able to touch them down their back, we can touch their neck, we can touch their legs, we can get a good feel of them, see how their body condition is, see if they have any issues. Now, a big concern with caribou and a lot of deer species are ticks. You might have heard of us talking about that in our Facebook Live with the moose. So ticks are carriers of disease. So we, as a part of getting our caribou in this training chute, we can apply tick prevention medication. So again, these animals are participating in their own health care, and they come in easily every morning to get their breakfast, and they absolutely love it. Okay, so we're gonna let Raven out. Now, there she comes. All right, so that's what we do with our caribou every morning. So I just wanna thank you guys again for joining us for another Facebook Live. Again, I hope everyone is staying safe, practicing good social distancing, and we hope you tune in tomorrow at 1 p.m. for another Facebook Live. Bye, everyone.